Hello guys, this is Lucy, and probably no one cares, but I would like to record a video about my hair transformation the first time in New York. So I plan to do my own hair color in the weekends, but before that, I don't want to mess up, ending up like a disaster, so I decided to go to like a professional hairdresser to cut my hair off first. Then I can dye it whatever color I want. I just finished doing my makeup and this is the original hair length. So I decided to cut off this part that is colored. I haven't redo my hair for a year, so that's why it looks so crappy. But we're gonna fix it this weekend. Hopefully it's a big success. I doubt that, but I just got back home from Sally's, which is a professional, I don't know if it's professional, but like there's a hair product beauty store just like a few blocks away from here. I think it's very famous for hair products. And firstly, I changed into my boyfriend's t-shirt, a very old one. I don't think he's gonna use it anyway. So this is what I got. I got this dedusted extra strength powder lightener. A 30 volume developer, which set to be able to lighten up my dark hair color. Hopefully it works. And I got a mixing bowl and some brushes. And for the toner, I'm going with T11 from the brand Wella. I really wish that I could go with something a little bit more playful, but this time I choose to be a little bit like more neutral. So if I mess up, it's not gonna be that bad. You know, hopefully my mom wouldn't kill me after watching this, but, and also like all of my hairdressers back in Taiwan wouldn't cringe after watching this, but I don't know, who cares? Like, I don't think anyone's watching this, so. Enough of nagging, let's get started. Okay, so for preparation, I'm gonna to comb my hair and separate the part that I wanted to dye and the part that I'm just gonna keep. Some of the parts I'm just, I mean like most of the parts I'm just gonna keep it dark, so my mom wouldn't freak out after watching me do this. So these are the inspiration photos that I really want to do. I think it's a little bit playful, but it is still suitable for most of the people. It's not too much, it's still got that extra lit in your style, so. And firstly, I'm just gonna comb my hair and separate it in the center line of my hair. I'm gonna turn this on. It's a little dark right now, okay. Yeah. Okay, hopefully I don't mess this up. I'm so afraid right now. I'm not even putting anything on and I'm already like freaking out, but okay. So I guess I'm gonna leave this up, this part up. Okay, so I just finished sectioning my hair. It looks so ridiculous right now. Like you can see, okay. You could see how I sectioned it. So every part down are the parts that I would like to do those highlights on. And all of these are the ones that I'm keeping in black. I am pouring 140 ml of this developer in this bowl. So, oh my god, 140, I guess this is enough. No. 6 scoops of this whitening powder. Okay. And I'm just gonna, so that
that is, I feel like making pancakes right now. Of course, this is inedible. Okay. So I'm just gonna mix it up. I also prepared some of these foil papers. Hopefully I'm gonna use it later. So I'm just gonna mix everything up. And I'm just gonna stir, stir, stir until the texture goes well. It's so weird. I feel like I have to put up a mask or something. It's so creepy. Like everything is flowing all over the place. Oh my god, I should shut up, right? Oh my god. I'm just so nervous because this is the first time bleaching my hair my own and it's kind of freaking me out. It is kind of freaking me out. Like, oh no, it's gonna sting, huh? No, it's, oh no, oh! That smells awful. Okay, now it all makes sense. Like, it's kind of weird for me because the developer and the light turner itself, it doesn't smell. But this, now, just smells like salon. Oh my god, oh my god. Okay. I have to calm down. Turn off this light. And this is one milky color right now, it looks like. Yogurt or ice cream, but it smells so bad and I didn't expect this to happen. Oh my god. I mean, it's kind of cool. It's kind of like science, you know, like mixing things up and a volcano just exploded. Something like that. Okay. So, oh my god, that's a bad idea, huh? Oh my god, I think I'm freaking out right now, but let me see if I have a paper. Okay, I've heard that using your own hands are faster and actually a little bit more even. So I'm just gonna do that. Oh my god, here it comes. Oh no. I didn't put this on your scalp first because it's gonna get lighter. And we don't want that. Oh my god, that smells so bad. Oh my god. That smells very bad. Okay, so I'm just gonna put this in, put this in. Okay, I really hope this doesn't hurt. Oh no. Okay, I'm gonna take, oh my god, I didn't expect this to be so messy. Oh no, I didn't do the top of my, should I rub it out? Should I? I'm just gonna rub it out though. You know what? I'm giving up on this. Oh my god, it actually stings. This smells so bad, I'm getting concerned. Like, it stings my eyes, it stings my nose, it smells horrible. Like, seriously, it smells horrible. Like, how could things smell this horrible? Okay, give me a moment. I'm gonna put this, I'm gonna get this right in the mirror from the bathroom. Okay, so I just put on the first layer and now it's like a hella mess, but I don't know. I don't know. I have a bad feeling of this. Like, it smells so, so bad. And the part that touches my face actually hurts. Ow. I mean, it just looks like it's lightening up very, very fast, which is kind of scary for me. I didn't know that it actually works out this well, but let's see. It actually changed faster for the root since we have like body heat to heat up it faster. So I'm just gonna apply them on the rest of my roots. Okay, so I just finished putting on roots and I just left like a shower cap on my head. So my glasses are so dirty, it's just with all this bleach. So just a reminder, if you wanted to bleach your hair, don't put your glasses on. It's gonna look so ridiculous. Like, I just look horrible now. There are like pieces of bleaches on my eyeglasses right now. So I'm just gonna leave it there for another 5 minutes and then I'll rinse my hair off and see how it looks. Okay. So I just got out of the shower. So off the hair ends of my hair looks a little bit darker than I expected it would be. I did put on like a box dye a couple of months ago, so my hair kind of stick into its colors and it left this brownish look. And the roots, it actually looks quite nice. And to be fair, this is my first time. I wouldn't want to be like too harsh on myself. But as you can see, I was putting on glasses, so some of the spots there are still dark brown. So I'm just gonna fix that. I'll probably bleach it again later because my hair does feel okay right now. And that is the back of my hair. It doesn't look horrible, but not the best way I want it for now, since it's so uneven. I'm gonna dry my hair and put on a new layer of bleach. Yeah. Okay, so I just dried my hair and now I look literally like a pudding. See? That's so ridiculous. And I figured that I missed some spots on the roots and like the back of my hair. There's like a missing spot. I didn't figure that when I'm putting bleach on because I was freaking out. I'm just gonna leave it like this. I think it's light enough. It's a little bit uneven, but I think it's okay for now. My hair look damaged, but I'm not gonna do another layer because I'm afraid that my hair is gonna fall out. So next, I'm gonna put on some toner with this developer, and I think it will get way better after rinsing this off. It's gonna look better and more even, and I don't look like a weird pudding when I put my hair up like this. Okay, so I'm just gonna forward to that. This toner, I'm gonna put like, I don't know if 40 ml is enough for this, but I'm just gonna put 20 ml, and for this I'm gonna put in 40. So I don't know if that makes sense, but let's see. This smells very bad, so the toner itself smells weird, like so long already. So I'm just gonna put on my gloves. During COVID times, I did buy a lot of gloves, so that's a good thing. I don't have to reuse the glove. I could just pick up a new one and apply this directly to my hair. Oh my god, it's dripping. I'm afraid. Is it normal for the toner to drip? Like, it's so watery. Like, the consistency is definitely different from the bleach. Okay, I'm just gonna, you know what? I'm just gonna use my head. Okay, see you later. It's so weird that the toner turns a little bit purple. I know that, you know, the purplish color cancels out the yellowness of your hair, so hopefully it will turn out a little bit more natural without, you know, uneven spots. And I'm gonna wait for it for like 30 minutes and wash it off. And hopefully everything's gonna be okay. I wouldn't look ridiculous because I still have to go to the office tomorrow. Hopefully. This is the current state of the bathroom. Like, everything is all over the place. I know it looks awful, but I'm gonna take it down. You can see that definitely there's something going on right here. Yeah.
I just finished washing my hair.
I put my hair down and now it looks all natural and black. But boop, boop. Yeah. I mean, it doesn't look that bad, but the roots part definitely looks way lighter as it is, but I can deal with that putting more hair dye after a couple of weeks later. I'm not pretty mad at this. Just gonna blow dry my hair and see if everything looks okay. This is the final look. I'm actually pretty happy with it. I mean, it's not that obvious when I put my hair down. This makes me feel a little bit edgy, but you know, it's not too much. I don't think my mom's gonna kill me after seeing me with the style. Definitely still conservative enough for most people. And I actually love it. Like, wow. The only thing I would say is that my roots, like, they are so dead white and look so ridiculous, but I think I can fix that someday. Probably like dye other colors after my bleached hair. So I'm not mad about it. Oh, and this would be the back of the hair. I actually can see it. What does it look like? Okay. You can't really tell when all of my hair is covered, but you know, like the wind blowing, it's gonna sneak out a little bit of this dramatic color, I would say. I would probably recommend anyone to go to a hair salon if you have that extra cash. But for me, I'm okay with this. I'm gonna think about what other colors I'm gonna do next time. So, how do you guys think about it? I actually like it. Oh my god. Oh my god, I actually love it. Oh my god. I actually look so edgy and dreamy. I actually love it. Oh my god. I mean, it's not flawless. Like, there's still a lot of flaws. A lot of uneven going on, but since it is hidden in the other layer of the hair, it doesn't really make a big deal of it, so yeah. So let me know what you think. I think the results are okay, and hopefully let's catch up soon. Bye.
Okay, one update. After a couple of days later, I did accidentally left a little bit of a bleach on the bed sheet and throw it into the washing machine, and turns out into these weird brownish color. It was originally like a very deep shade of gray. So just be careful. Don't leave any other fabrics close to it or you're gonna end up like this. Oh no, it looks so terrible right now. It's originally like dark gray.